aware of where we're going. Yeah. We're trying to carry a bit more speed. The more speed we carry, the more we have to look ahead.
Yes.
Especially in the slaloms, because it's so easy when you go through a slalom, you focus on the car, and then you can come out of it and go, oh, where do I go? Mm-hmm. And in both of these cases, we have to sort of jink to the left and do a turnaround.
Yeah.
And we have a turnaround coming out pretty quick on that one. All right. Where are we? I break hard, mm-hmm. And then I turn. I try and brake and turn at the same time, it doesn't look very well. Car will just go straight on. Tires don't do so much. So again, that's why if, when you're in a turn and you mash the gas, mm-hmm. they're already at the limit. You mash the gas, the back end is just going to go.
It's gone.
You always have to manage the load, especially on the rear tires. All right.
Thank you.
the gas and on the gas hard. I don't want the brakes and on the brakes hard. But you don't want to go dive bombing. If you dive, if you go in so hard and dive bombing, you better be a little concerned on the brakes and be on the car under control. And you know, experience tells you how much you can do that, because this car is tricky. And it's not a front-wheel drive on the steering monster.
Yes.
You know. Alright, whenever you're ready. Keep the car out to the right. Much better through the left-hander.
Yeah.
And, you know, you were a little cautious on the brakes, but that was fine. But I'd rather, much rather see that than dive bombing in there and smashing it all down, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to be, when we come out of that exit down there, you got on the gas a little too hard and then and then backed off, you'd be much better off just, again, waiting for the car turned a little bit more, getting a little straighter so it starts to unload before you squeeze on the gas. You imagine the wheel attached to your throttle, and as you unwind the wheel, then you can squeeze on the gas.
Okay.
But if you're still cranked, don't do it.
Don't
if you wait till you start to unwind the wheel, imagine they're connected.
Yeah.
Right? Squeeze on the gas.
Gotcha.
All right. Starts on the exit of the turnaround, getting close to that one with the car already turned. So you can actually let the car, you know how, I didn't quite as deep as I went, or to the outside wall, but somewhere in the middle there. You don't actually need to be close to the that middle cone.
Mm-hmm.
Let the car go down and you give it a better angle coming out.
So a better angle and you carry more speed.
Right, exactly.
Don't use the
all about
so
angles.
Much.
But you're really doing a great job. Your first time, it's great.
Thank you.
Some people automatically kind of get it, and some people don't know. it'll never happen. But you're very smooth. You're good. All right, over to the right-hand side. Set up the corner. Trying to get on the gas where you should, but the car's not fully turned yet.
Yeah.
If you let the car come down or up the runway a little bit more in the middle, you'll be at that angle when you can do that, and it'll set you up better for these next two turns. Because
okay.
I think you're losing most of the time through that little section there before the crossover. The rest of it is actually really pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
You get the car over to the left in the crossover, but then you kind of turn in a little early.
A little early.
So you end up going keep the car out and sort of lead apex a little bit more.
Okay.
And then you have to carry more speed down into the slalom.
So straighten up more coming out of that first comeback.
Yeah.
And then stay more to the left on the cut through.
Okay. You want me to do one more, swap over and then back again?
Sure.
You don't need to drive faster. We just put the car in the right spots, right?
Yeah. Great job. Thank you very much.
Well done. See how drama-free that was? And it was your best run. Yeah?